There are approximately 40 to 100 trillion microorganisms that live symbiotically on a human body. Altogether, it is estimated that they weigh about 2 kilograms, nearly 4.5 pounds, and most of them are bacteria. One of those, Escherichia coli, is a rod-shaped bacteria which can commonly be seen in the intestines of warm-blooded animals, including humans. Each is approximately 1 to 2 micrometers long and 1/4 to 1 micrometer wide, with a volume of 0.6 to 0.7 cubic micrometers. In the human intestine, there are finger-shaped bumps called villi. These villi help to increase the absorption of nutrients. On these bumps are tiny hairs called microvilli, each approximately 1 millimeter in length, where E. coli usually adheres. The length of the large intestine with the villi is about 180 centimeters long, and the internal diameter is about 5 centimeters. Now, imagine a man who is 180 centimeters tall, or 5'11". In this man's large intestine, there is a tiny 1 millimeter villus, and on this villus lives a 1 micrometer E. coli. Let's call this E. coli coal. Now, suppose Cole became a person 180 centimeters tall. He works in a building 1,800 meters high, 3 times taller than the One World Trade Center, the highest building in America. That's one enormous villus. Its base covers an area approximately 90 kilometers in diameter, which would take an hour to drive across by car. Imagine that this giant villus and area are located inside a host that is approximately 3,240 kilometers tall. That would be slightly shorter than the distance across the United States from east to west, or 1/4 of the Earth's diameter, almost the same as the diameter of the moon. Or if we think of it in terms of area, it would be similar to the combined size of the states of New York and Pennsylvania. Back to Cole. He has a lot of friends. Some manufacture products, some solve problems that arise, and some catch offenders. And there are offenders who can cause serious problems. If Cole's friends don't find those causing serious problems, it can become a problem to the host as well. Since 2007, the National Institute of Health, NIH, along with 80 laboratories around the world, has been decoding gene information of the microorganisms living inside the human body for the Human Body Microbiome Project. So far, there have been about 10,000 types of microorganisms identified in our bodies. According to current research, the large intestine hosts the most varied microorganisms in the human body. Around 4,000 types of bacteria can be found throughout the body, 1,300 types inside the mouth, 900 types inside the nasal passages, 800 types on the inside of the cheek, and 300 types inside the vaginal area. The type and distribution of microorganisms vary depending on where they are in the body, and they also vary from person to person. To bacteria, the human body is like an ecosystem where many bacteria can coexist. If you were a bacterium, then the person you were living in would seem like the size of a small planet. Perhaps we could say that bacteria live in symbiotic balance inside a planet called human. When this balance breaks, it sometimes negatively affects the human as well. Taking a wider view, humans are like tiny beings that live in symbiosis with a planet called Earth. Could humans be parasites on an enormous being that exists in space? If humans break the balance of the ecosystem, it may have a negative impact not only on the Earth, but also across space.